Calculating out the right spring rate for an independent suspension can seem pretty daunting, but we're going to show you just how simple it can be. All right, I'm Trevor and I've got Bill with me today. And today we're going to discuss how to appropriately calculate a spring rate for an independent suspension. And this can be a front independent or rear independent. Same principle applies there. But when you might be experiencing this is if you have a, you know, custom chassis car that you're going to outfit with coilovers, or you've got an aftermarket tubular front end, or even if you're just retrofitting in some custom mount, you know, shocks and springs into a, you know, some stock independent suspension that just doesn't have any direct fit coilovers for it. So it's a pretty simple procedure really and calculation, but you will need some known weights and measurements, and Bill and I will get into that and show you how easy it is. So we got to start out with vehicle weight, and more specifically, we need to know, you know, we're going to go through an example today of a typical front end weight. So I need to know what my vehicle's front end weighs. And I'd say for this scenario, let's say my front end weighs 1,500 pounds.
All right, 1,500 pound total weight.
Total weight, yep. I rolled it on a set of scales, put some scales under it, it's 1,500 pounds.
And with any suspension, we've talked about this before, what we need to know is the amount of weight that is actually being supported by the springs.
Okay.
So that is not gonna include your wheels, tires, brakes, spindles, you know, those kinds of things. So in this scenario, I'm going to use a pretty round number that's very common for a lot of the stuff that we see and what we work on.
Right.
And that's 150 pounds. So if we take 1500 minus 150, we get 1350. That's how much weight is being supported by the springs. Now there's two springs. So we need to divide that by two, because each spring is going to be supporting half of that. So that's 675 pounds.
Okay.
Right, because we're calculating the spring rate for a single spring.
Right.
So you know what to buy.
Yeah, yep.
Right? So the next thing we need to know, now we know essentially how much weight is going to be supported by these springs. We need to know what length spring you're going to be using. And we're in this scenario, we're assuming that you've already worked out your shocks, you've watched our other videos, you've worked out your shock and spring length.
Okay.
So what spring length are you going to be running in this particular car?
Let's say I'm going to need a 10-inch spring.
So our 10-inch spring. And we want that to compress about 30% for a general purpose street car, you know, high performance kind of thing.
Yeah.
So times 30%. Equals 3 inches. Okay, so that means we want our 10-inch spring to compress 3 inches underneath this 675 pounds.
Okay.
So all we got to do there, because spring rate is pounds per inch, we just take our pounds, divide by inch, right? So if we go 675 divided by 3 inches, we get 225 pounds per inch.
Okay. Yeah, and that is a spring rate then.
That's exactly what that is.
Okay.
Yep. So we've got 225 pounds. Now, here's where it gets slightly different for independent suspensions.
Yeah.
So you've got a control arm here, and the control arm is pivoting here, and it's being acted on way out here. The shock, though, is way in the middle. So we need the measurement from the pivot to the ball joint.
Okay.
And from the pivot to the shock mount. So here's our ball joint, here's our control arm, here's our pivot. Here's our shock mount. So let's just assume we got a 16-inch control arm from pivot to ball joint. The shock mount is right in the middle at 8 inches.
Okay.
What this is saying is that if this is pivoting here and you're pushing up or pulling up on this ball joint out here,
yep.
You've got this much leverage on that much spring.
Okay.
Essentially. So we're going to take 16 divided by 8. which equals 2. And what that really is a ratio. It's 2 to 1, which means that we've got 2 units of measurement from here to here versus 1 unit of measurement from here to here.
That makes sense. And I should mention in this case, the shock mount happens to be halfway in between the control arm, 8 inches. But if it is further outboard, we need to know pivot point to shock mount, not ball joint to shock mount. So just so that's clear, the pivot point on the arm to the shock mount would be our number that we divide the overall length by.
Yep. So in this scenario, we've got a 2 to 1 ratio, which is actually really common in a lot of the stuff that we see and we work on.
Yeah.
So now, because we've got 2 times the leverage on the shock, which is what that's saying, mm-hmm. we just multiply this by 2. So we take this, we bring it all the way down here. We've got 225 times 2 equals 450 pounds per inch.
Nice.
So that is the spring rate that I would recommend for that. If you called up and said, hey, my front end weight's 1500 pounds, I have this control arm geometry, I would say, okay, 450 pound spring is gonna do you really well in this case.
Yeah, that seems really straightforward.
Now, if your shock mount's further out here and you've got an angle to the shock, you can get into angle correction stuff. And we've done that in other videos. You can go look at our solid axle for a little bit more in-depth explanation of that. It's the same principle. You would just take this number divided by your angle correction factor. Now, if you wanted a drag race, you could go more on your more on your percentage here. You could go, 35-40%, and then you'll get a lower rate.
Yep.
Things like that. If you're autocrossing, you could go little less on that, maybe 20%.
Yeah, this gets us really close for just about 90% of what we're ever gonna do with the car. Well, I hope you guys learned how easy it can really be to calculate starting spring rate for an independent suspension here. And of course, if you need any assistance with that, we're always happy to help. Grab that vehicle weight and those control arm measurements, and we'll get you on the road.